is this we have continued the series of design pattern. We will discuss about design pattern. In previous window, one topic was left. Because of the time problem, I forgot to tell you that. So the forgotten design pattern was one design pattern was left. Static factory method. Static factory method is a part of creational design pattern, and creation in this is also very similar to factory design pattern. This is very similar to the factory design pattern. It is nothing. It's not very different, but little bit different. But we are using here static things. We are using static things. Let's see. Just let's take an example of electricity board. In electricity board, you are consuming electricity. You have to pay the bill according to the plan. If you are having a commercial plan, you are having a domestic plan or institutional plan or something else. So for different type of plans, they are having different type of rates of as per rate. So let's see. So I have created one class that is commercial plan. So plan is my abstract class. Here I am using a abstract class. So abstract class is the rate. This, because we have defined this rate class rate variable in an abstract class, so at the time of child class, this variable will be inherited over there. So we can use this abstract class as a remote control to pass. So here we are using inheritance. Here we are using inheritance. So we can get the rate of rate of charges, and we can compute the bill on the basis of rate. Just we have to pass the unit. So commercial plan, for commercial plan extended with the plan, so rate is inherited from the top class from plans. So rate variable is coming from there, and we can change the value at runtime. And for domestic plan, we are having this value, and for institution we are having different value. So according to that value, we can generate the bill. And this is my abstract factory. This is my factory class. This is my factory class, which is responsible to generate the bill. What type of bill I want, we can generate. So we have to pass which plan we are having. So I'm having the plan, domestic plan, commercial plan, institutional plan, or whatever. So using the constructor, this is the method. We have to pass the plan, and according to the plan, it will give me the domestic plan, commercial plan, or institutional plan object. And according to the object, we will generate the revenue. So let's see the example. So again, I'm going to remind you, do not forget to read this comments. Comments are very important here. Static factory method is not same as the factory method. Little bit same, but not complete one. That is why it is a different one from the design pattern. This technique is similar to the flyweight. Flyweight design pattern, I'll tell you later in next the same video. Static method, and it returns the instance of the class. And here a simple example from the boolean and box primitive class. Boxing on box, so you might be knowing that to convert the primitive to non-primitive, non-primitive to primitive data types, that is called boxing and unboxing. And this method translate a boolean primitive value into the boolean just object reference. A class can have only a single constructor with a given signature, and programmer have to know the get around this restriction by providing two constructors. Those parameters list differ from differ only in the order to the parameter type, and this is a really bad idea. The users of such an API will never be able to remember which constructor is which, and which will be end up they calling the wrong by mistake. And people reading code that uses these constructor will not know what the code does without referring to the class. User cannot know. The first advantage of that, they have the name and a static factory method do not share the restriction discussed in the previous paragraph. In case where a class seems to require the multiple constructor with the same signature, replace the constructor with the static factory method and carefully chosen name to highlight their differences. Second advantage is a static factory method is that unlikely constructor, they are not required to create a new instance, a new object each time they are invoked. This allows the immutable class to use pre-constructed instance or the cache instance as they are constructed and dispense them repeatedly to avoid the creating unnecessary duplicate objects at the boolean dot value of boolean. The method illustrate this technique, and this never create an object, and this technique is similar to the flyweight pattern, and this can greatly improve the performance if equivalent objects are requested often, especially if they are expensive to create. So flyweight is very similar to the flyweight. Flyweight is just like a telephone line. So we'll discuss later in next time. So we are going to create the factory. So get factory plan. So I created an object of factory plan. This is the factory, and I have to put the number of units which I have generated. Let's assume 200 unit, and okay, again I have to run because I have to give the plan, which plan I have executed. Domestic plan generated 200, so my rate is 700. So we can generate revenue like this. So this is my buffered reader, and I'm going to take the input from the command line, and this is reading the line and parse the integer and plan, particular plan, and this is getting the rate and calculating the value. And value of if b is true or false, so we can check that. So this is nothing. If I want to comment that, we can comment. So this will not affect anything. So let's move to another one. Okay, let's come back. So next design pattern is structural. The way of designing the structure of object, how object will designed. So here we will cover that. So first one is design pattern is proxy. Proxy is nothing, it's just about to provide the assistance to the another object. Let's say example, you are having a bank account, but you cannot take bank all the time with you. So that's why bank has given you one card, debit card, and debit card is nothing, it's just a replica of bank. So whenever you require the money, or if you want to withdraw some amount, you could just go to the ATM, and on the behalf of ATM, on the behalf of your card, with the security credential, it will give you dispense the money according to that. So you can say it's a nothing, it's just an object representation to another object. So a card is a debit card is just a representation of bank, but directly you are interacting with the bank. So let's see the example, working example. So in this example, we are going to discuss, we have created one interface, that is image. Image, one method is to display, and this is one class which implements image method, image interface. These are the two parameters, variables we have, instance variable we have defined here, and this is a constructor. We can pass the value using constructor, and this method is overridden method which is defined in a image class. So system real image equals to null, system dot real image, this one, and real image we can pass. And another is, this is a proxy image, so this will work as a mediator, and this is the actual real image. So this is also implement the image. So real image load from the disk, and this is writing to the system, and this is a method. Let's see in a text class how to test that. Public static void main, generally I created that. So image, image proxy. So this is my image, which one I want to give, and image dot display image, and system dot out dot println. We are going to display image. Okay, let's run the program. So initially real image was null, so I'm putting the image name is this one. Going to display the proxy name is, so I'm calling the another object, that is mediator object, and displaying the real image, this one, and going to display the another image is, this is the proxy image, this is the proxy image. And you can see here the real image is written to proxy image. Using proxy image we are transmitting the data information to another object, but proxy is nothing, it's just a mediator object. Another design pattern is decorator. You can check all the design patterns, even I tell you each and everything. So decorator, let's say decorator is nothing, something is already there, but we are putting something extra on it. Let's say you are going for having a chaat pakodi, and you are asking him to give us some extra water, you are asking some extra chutney or something else. So this is nothing, it's a free of cost, but for good reputation, shopkeeper will give you some extra thing. It's nothing else, it's a, or that shopkeeper can give you some discount as well. So let's suppose you are going to order the pizza, they are having some 4 or 5 type of pizza, but they are giving you some discount on particular type of pizza, and they are giving some additional things on cheese or something, additional things that they are putting on the pizza. So let's assume that you are having a 10 type of pizzas, and you are having a 3 type of toppings, some decorating things. So and you want to apply discount as well. So like this, you have to provide, you have to create 30 classes plus discount classes, means minimum 60 classes you have to create. But design pattern says you can put something additional in their same class as well. So let's see example. So I have created one class, circle class. So any example you can take, whatever real time example I am so telling you, and computer as example, both I am suggesting you, each and every example you can take. So I created one class circle, implement with a shape. Shape is my interface. In shape we have one method is draw. So the draw, we are going to draw the circle, we are going to draw the rectangle, and this is a red shape decorator. So that whatever border is, whatever design is there, whatever shape is created, I'm just putting the color to the border color to that particular design. So how to achieve that? So we are having a one class shape decorator. Shape decorator is all implements the interface shape one. Shape one. And shape decorator. Shape decorator implements a shape, and shape interface object we have created, and it will load into the memory. And this is a constructor. I can pass any type of shape here, and we are going to draw the shape because it's a part of shape. That's why. So I am on particular shape, I am going to put the border red color. So how to achieve that? I have to pass the constructor. I have to pass the shape into the constructor. Then I'll draw. But I want to put some extra things on that. So this is not putting. This is not additional there. So this is additional for this particular class only. So this method I created, and I'm putting some extra things. So this is my extra things, and today you can put a discount, another days you can put something else, green color, yellow color, or something else. Let's see example. Let's run our code, and again I'm telling you, do not forget to read these commands. These are very important here. So in shape we have created one shape. Shape is circle, and I create one shape is shape red shape, and I created one more red shape rectangle. I can pass any rectangle or circle, something, or this is a plane shape. So I can draw normal circle, red color circle, and rectangle circle. Just run that. So there at runtime I'm putting the functionality. I'm just changing the functionality. I'm just changing functionality at runtime according to the requirement. So this is a decorator pattern, and next one is facade. Facade design pattern is nothing, it's just a business logics, nothing else. This facade design pattern is being implemented in a business logics. Let's say example, you are going to organize some party, like marriage party, but you cannot manage each and everything by yourself. So you have to hire one event manager. Event manager will take care of all the parts, and event manager would be having a particular different specialized team, like a decoration, food, invitation, music, or DJ, something. So like this you can have different things, and you can query each and every things related to the party to the event manager. Event manager is only responsible. So this is a one gateway. So event manager will work as a gateway. So And you can take an example like a customer care service. If you are going to call the customer care service, they will attend you, and if you are not happy with them, they will forward your call to some other. But direct, you cannot directly reach to them, their senior person or something else. So here telecaller or customer care executive is working as a facet design pattern. It's a one gateway. So let's see the example. So I created one shape. I created one shape, shape 0, and draw. And I have a circle implemented shape 0, and circle implementation I did. Rectangle, I'm doing a rectangle implementation, and a square, I'm putting a square implementation. And this is our main gateway. So this is our main gateway. If I want to interact with a circle, rectangle, and another square, so this one gateway is will provide me each and everything. So how we have designed the gateway? So this is one class. We have created all the objects related to the shape type of object, constructor, and shape maker. We are going to draw the shape. If we want to draw the shape, then each and every method will draw the circle or rectangle according to their credential. They will draw the shape. If the object is related to the circle, the object is related to the rectangle, related to the square, and rest of the is draw circle, draw rectangle. These are just method we have defined. Draw rectangle, circle, and we can define n number of methods. So let's run our code. So do not forget to read this thing. These comments are very important here. Facet design pattern hide the complexity of the system and provide the interface to the client, using which client can access the system. This type of design pattern comes under the structural design pattern, as the pattern adds the interface to the existing system to hide the complexity. And this pattern involves the single class which provides a simplified method required by client and delegates calls to member method of existing system classes. So we created one test class, and we created object of, this is a one gateway, shopkeeper, shape maker. We created object, and using shape maker we can draw the circle, we can draw the rectangle, we can draw the square. So whatever we want we can achieve. So you know, so this one you can see is, it will draw the circle, this. So let's run this. So I'm inside the circle, I'm inside the rectangle, I'm inside the square, right? So next one is adapter. Let's see the example. What is adapter? Adapter is nothing, just it's a converter. It's just a converter. Let's say at your home power is coming as 220 volt as alternating current, AC current. But to charge your mobile phone, to charge your laptop, or to charge something else, so you need some type of adapter that will convert the AC current to DC current according to the specification of your device. So your charger is working as an adapter. A charger is also known as adapter. Let's another example. You are having iPhone, but I'm using Android phone. Really, I'm an Android lover. So I want to charge my phone, iPhone. Then how would I? So I need one type of adapter that will charge that can be connected ordinary charger, Android charger to that adapter. So I can charge my iPhone as well. So in real world example, you can see I went to Bangladesh in Dhaka. In Dhaka there are different type of sockets are available, but in India we are using different type of software, different type of plug point, round pin plug point. But in Dhaka, Bangladesh, they are using rectangle type of plug points. So I need one adapter, so I use there. And in India directly I can use round shaped pin. Okay, so let's see the example in code. Adapter, so this is adapter. So let's see another example also. You are having one pen and you don't want to share with me that pen, and I asked you and you told me that I have a pen but that is not working properly. I can give you empty pen without ink. So what I do, I will take one adapter and I'll arrange something from someone, and then I'll join that, and I will write my something. I'll write assignment, I'll write a letter or something else. So we need some third party utility that is being used as a adapter. So let's see that. I want to write assignment. So assignment, I have one pen but I don't have its implementation. It's a blank pen, I don't have its implementation, but pen should write. So I want to write assignment. So in assignment I have to take pen, I have to take the pen, and it will return the pen object, but pen is need to be assigned there. So we need a pen adapter. Without pen adapter I cannot write my assignment. So adapter is working, is nothing, it's just you are putting a refill into the your pen. So your colleague is providing you the pen, only blank pen, nothing else, without refill. So it's my adapter, it's implement pen. So I will implement that adapter for pen, and this is my pilot pen. I have another class, and in pilot pen I have implementation for the pilot pen adapter. This is a pen adapter. So pilot pen is going to write not that pen, but going to write is pilot pen, not that pen which is your friend is provided you. So pilot pen is a class that is having we have to write. Let's see the example. So pilot pen is a pen adapter. We have to create the object of pen. It will return me a pen with refill, as I gave you the example. And this is assignment. I have to create the assignment object, and then I have to put the pen for on assignment. Then I will start my assignment. I will start writing my assignment. So let's see. So I'm from the pen adapter. So pen adapter is working now, and I'm from the pilot pen, not from that pen, it is from pilot pen, arranged pen. Okay, so now let's go into flyweight. flyweight. Flyweight is nothing. Let's say you are in old time. Old time means just if you go in 10 years back, in 2004 or 5, that time I was used to make a call from the landline phone. And from the landline phone, BSNL phone, landline phone. So most of the time, BSNL landline phones were busy. So you may ask, generally heard this song, all routes are busy. So all routes are busy, what's the meaning of this? It means BSNL have only 5 or 6 line or 10 line or 100 lines, but on those limited number of lines, BSNL have distributed n number of telephone lines. So once, if I want to speak to someone, I will dial my phone and that same line, phone line will work for me. Once I cut phone, another user can use the same phone line. Dynamically they are going to allot. If all lines are busy, then I have to keep in waiting. So this is an example of flyweight. This is a real-time example, a real-life example, and let's have a look on code. In code, I have a shape class interface. Most of the example I will use the shape interface, or just I love that. So in this interface have a one method draw. In this draw method, circle, we created one class that is implemented with the shape, and shape maybe shape may have a color, may have a x coordinate, y coordinate, and its radius according to that, and whatever I want. So if I'm going to call this circle, then circle would be what type of circle, color, which color circle I want, what would be the location of the circle, what would be the radius of the circle, and using the constructor we can pass the parameters. And public circle, new color, this is another constructor we can call the only this constructor, we can call this constructor, and according to the requirement, rest of this getter, setter, nothing else. And one method we are having draw. This draw method we are going to put the just nothing, it's just a system.out.println. Two string method we have overridden. So this is my one gateway. This is my one single gateway is shape factory. So shape factory, in shape factory we are going to define hash map. In hash map we are going to provide the key value pair, and it will hold the object type of shape. Shape may be any type of circle, rectangle, or whatever. In shape circle we have which type of color circle we want, we can put it. And let's run our code. So this is our code. I'm reminding you, do not forget to read this thing. These comments are very important here. Private, static, void, main, these few colors I have defined array, and public, static, void, main. I'm going to call the different type of circles. I'm going to draw the different type of circles, the different type of radius we can get, and those circle we are going to print. Let's run that. So you can see here, creating circle create a circle of blue, and blue what this is a dimension, this is a red, and this is a dimension for that, this is color white, this is black, or different type of circles we can draw. But same object I am using again and again. We are having limited type of colors and limited of objects, but again and again we are using the same. So next one is As I told you that this bridge is nothing, it's just a mediator, just a mediator between the two objects. So circle, we have created one class draw api is responsible to draw the circle, and this implemented on the shape is a class, abstract class. In abstract class we are having a one method, and this is a one interface draw api. So we are using here bridge, so this one will work as a bridge. So red circle, if I want to draw the red circle, then I have to implement draw api. Send draw api, what could be the radius of the circle and what would be the dimension for the circle. Location, green circle, red circle, and let's take a look on here. Please read this one, do not public static void main, and I want to draw this circle red color circle. So just I create the object of circle class, these are dimension, and I have to pass the object of the red circle class, green circle class, and I can draw. Internally it is going to take care of it. So 10 draw red circle is 100 by 100. So this is the dimension red, and this is a radius, this is the radius, and this is the dimension the location of that. So another is composite. Composite is nothing. Composite means we are in, it's a type of encapsulation. So you can see here, I created one class, employee class. In employee class we have created a constructor, we are having getter setters, we can have n number of employees, list also we can have a same class object as well, different under one employee can have n number of employees. So we can add n number of employees here, and this is my class. So let's run this class. Okay, so you can see here, employee name is this one, and under this how many employees are working under this employee. So this is a CEO, under CEO how many employees are working, and this is Robert, and head of the sales, this is a sales department, this is a sales executive. So we can create the hierarchy, and we can put this salary, how much salary they are getting. So composite is nothing, it's a, we are creating hierarchy object, hierarchical objects. So in this, like this, this is called composite. Composite entity is a just same, but we are using in different classes. Composite entities we have created, and print data, and data we have printed here, set. If you want to run this, please read this one. If you do not read, then you will not understand very well. So you can see here, data going to test, and once data is done with the test, then second test will be gone, then another data, step by step we are doing the same thing as a step by step. We have created a hierarchy for testing. So this is based on the entities. So this is the entities, normal class we have created, and this one is an instance variable, getter setters, same thing we added here, getter setters, same, and this is a composite entity, this is a main gateway, composite entity. Main gateway is client. So in client, composite entity is working, and we can print the data. So this is a client, is a main gateway. Yes. DAO, this is the most important design pattern. DAO, data and data access object. So this is used to access the data. DAO, this is a very important part of handling with model classes, handling model classes to retrieve the data. So let's say I have a student class. Student class name is string, roll number and getter status, and this is my DAO interface. Inside the interface we have defined so many methods and implementation I have given here. So what if I want to get the data, if I want to set the data, we can achieve directly, we can achieve it directly. So if I want to if I create the objects, automatically two objects will be saved into the list, and if I want to delete, I can delete the number of student, I can get the student, all the student, I can get the student by the roll number. So this is this type of implementation you can achieve in MVC design pattern, MVC design pattern, while you are interacting with the repositories, DAO repositories, from JPA or some other database you want to retrieve the object, you can use there. So let's run this, and again do not forget to read this one. Run this. So student roll number is 0, name is Robert, and student name is 1, student roll number 2 in John, and roll number 0 updated in line. So roll number 0 is updated. So now only this one have it. So this Robert is changed to Michael. So this is called DAO. Delegates. Delegates is nothing. It's just about to delegating the things. Is this type of design pattern implemented in EJB? EJB. So this is my interface. Interface's name is business service do processing, and implemented here. This business service interface is implemented here, and this method we have defined here, do processing, and we are going to define here processing here. So equals EJB, EJB service, EJMS, or maybe EJB service or JMS. This is completely part of the Java, so that is why you can see here in your platform maybe something else, but example would be like the same. So processing, I'm at a business lookup, I'm at a business lookup. This is business delegates. Business delegates is a main class. This is a main class. Business delegates, business lookups, we have created object and set services class, and do the business logics here. Client, so client, you are going to call, meet with the client. In client we have to call the business service. If business service is there, then only we can meet with the client. It will take the place at the time of instantiation. Class, client is a constructor. We are having a two task. So business service, what type of service we are giving, that service will in service you have to talk with them. EJB services, EJB service, we are passing processing task by invoking EJB services, we are pass processing task by JMS service. So different service services we are providing. When, like one company can provide multiple services, so but from the different departments. So let's see the example. So business delegates pattern is used. So I'm going to reach in conclusion. Business delegate pattern is used to decouple the presentation tier from the business tier. So we are decoupling, and it is basically used to reduce the communication to remote lookup, client representation tier in JSP, and servlet UI part. And business delegates a single entity point class for client and client entity to provide the access to the business services. So business delegates we have to provide this representation. Business lookup service object is responsible to get the relative business implementation and provide the business object access to the business delegate object. Business service interface concrete class implement this business service to provide actual business implementation logics. So let's run this. If some customer want to meet us, then business delegate is coming. So business delegate is the object we have created, and business delegate to which department they want to talk. They want to talk with the EJB, and this one want to talk to JMS. So different implementation both are doing, both work is different, but delegation is the one. Delegate one is JMS or different departments maybe. Okay, so next one is filter is nothing. Let's assume I have created one service that is used to give you the records, list of employees records. But think about the security. Anybody can access that data. I want to filter the request, then how can I cannot give access directly to the anyone. So I have to implement login forms, login credentials. I have to give the login credentials. If user is login, if he is providing a username password correctly, then only if authorization is correct, then only we are permitted to give access to him. Otherwise it will not accessible. So we are filtering the request. We are a good example is servlet filter in servlets. So servlet validation we can do using servlet filter. Request filtering we can do. So let's see example, real world example. Interface, public interface criteria, and we are having a person type of list. We can put it here, and this will return the same list. So, and criteria is what? This is the criteria. So, and criteria means this one also, another one also, both condition will be pass. And criteria and other criteria. So, both criteria it will add and put it here. And list service. List of the person will be given according to the criteria if it is fulfilling the criteria. And criteria for females, so this would be criteria for females. So if gender is female, then only it will filter all the genders. And this is for male filters. So if I want to only male, so I can add the male. If I want a single, then I can add this single. I want or single or married or something else. So or criteria also I can implement here. So you can see here criteria, both criteria I have implemented here. So this is my person class. Person can have, this is a normal getter setter class, POJO class. Let's run this. Run. So I have added in the beginning of the program, I have added few employees. They are male, female, single, married or something else. So and I want to create the criteria. This filter class you can use in Servlet, and this class you can use in Hibernate. In Hibernate there is a class called criteria. It works as the same in Hibernate as well. So this is just a sample code. Next time I'll create a video, I shoot video for Hibernate, that time I'll show you how criteria will work. So in criteria, female criteria, male criteria, single criteria. So in criteria, I want single and male. I want single or female. So different criteria I can put it here. So according to the requirement and person male criteria will print how many persons. And number of person will be print here. Correct. So you can see here the data is here. So this is my getter setter card, print person. So print person is whatever the marital status or something, whatever is there, we can print. Male criteria, only male person, print person, list of the person. List of the person. List of the person. Person I am passing. Person dot get name, get A, get O. Both are, we have put it here. Flyweight, front controller. Front controller is very important. This is a complete spring is based on the front end controller, dispatcher sublet. So how dispatcher sublet works, let's see here. So this is my dispatcher sublet, and in dispatcher sublet student view is there, home view is there, and this is my constructor, and going to dispatch the request to the student or show home. And this is my front controller. In front controller dispatcher, where I want to send user, front controller, and user authenticated or not, and track the request, whether requested page number is this. And home view, and home view we have given one method, show, and display a home page. And student displaying student view page. Let's test run this code. The front controller design pattern is used to provide the centralized request. Request is centralized, one gateway. Handling the mechanism so that all requests will be handled by a single handler, and this handler can do the authentication, authorization, logging or tracking for the request, and then pass the request to the corresponding handler. And following the entities are of this type of design pattern. Front controller, single handler for all kind of request. So all the requests, whatever requests are coming, this front controller will take care of it, and according to the requirement it will forward the request to some other. And dispatcher front controller may use the dispatcher object, which can dispatch the request to the corresponding handler. And view are the object which requests are made. View is the object which will be served for what requests are made. So let's run this. So we have created an object of front controller, and where I want to go, so I have to put the request I want to go on home page, I want to go on a student view page. So according to that, dispatcher will provide me the particular page. So you can see here, I'm asking for home. So page user requested a home page, and user is authenticated successfully. We have given the authentication and displaying the page. And user has requested the student page, and user authenticated successfully and displaying the page. So this is the front controller's spring. It's a part of spring. Intercepting filter. This is very similar to the filter, but intercepting, it's a, you can say it's a part of it's a combination of intercept filter and observer. Filter and observer. So let's see. So the intercepting filter design pattern is used when we want to do pre-processing. Pre-processing with the request or response to the application. Filters are defined and applied on the request before the passing the request. So they take place in the memory first. Actually, target application filters can do the authentication, authorization, logging and tracking of the request and then pass the request to the corresponding handler. Following are the entities of the type of design pattern. So filter manager, we have created one class manager. This is a one gateway using a filter manager. Which target we want to achieve? So in filter manager, authentication, debugging filter, and client, where what client want. So set filter managers, filter manager, and send the request to the home. Let's run this, then I'll explain it. Authenticating home, request log for home. And so this is logging the thing. As I told you, this is a type of observer class, observer design pattern, mixer of observer and filter. Is everything is monitoring. So this is my filter. So this is my filter and going to execute the request. And this is my authentication filter. This class will is responsible for implementing filters. And this is client class. Client is going to interact with the filter. So that is why filter manager is required. Filter manager. So whenever client will come, then filter manager will come into the light and will ask what you require. So they will ask filter manager. Filter manager constructor will be saved here and send the request to the requested one. Debugging filter. Debugging filter also another type of filter, and we are executing the task. Debugging for logging. This thing you can find in Android Studio while you are generating the lot of logs for testing records into the device. So most of the time we print the logs. Filter chain. So this is a responsible for filter chain. So all the filters list will come here, and we can filter add all the filters here, and we can execute the filters one by one, chain of request one by one, all the tasks. So this is responsible for executing all the tasks. So one by one, this is executing all the tasks and setting target. Filter manager, this is a filter manager, which is one gateway for client. Client will reach this and set the filter, filter request, and this is target. Target filter, target is also another type of filter. So this is the last one, and let's run this. So that's it for interceptor. And most important most important design pattern is MVC. Interviewer asks, which design pattern is most popular nowadays? Yes, that is MVC, Model View Control. Model View Control is completely based on the observer. So let's see how it works. So student, this is my POJO class, general POJO class, which we will persist in a database or somewhere else. So this is my POJO, plain POJO class, and this is my controller. This is my controller. So whenever request will come, student, whenever request will come, always request will be handled by the student controller. Student controller, and student will controller will take care will take care of model or view. Both with they have to pass here. Model and view both they have to pass here. And set student name. Set string name, getter setter, and we are updating the view. So this method, see this method. So in view, we are printing the student detail. Whatever student they need, we are putting the details here. And this is student view. So whatever student detail they want, they can get it from here. So this is view part, this is a model part, and this is a controller. So MVC, that's why we call it a MVC. So let's take an example. MVC stands for Model View Control, and this pattern is used to separate the application concern. Model View represents the data object, POJO class carrying the data, and it can also have logic to update controller if it data change. View is represents the visualization of the data that model contains, and controller is act as a both act on both view and model. It controls the data flow into the model object and update to the view whenever data changes to the system, and it keeps view and view model separate. Let's run this and see, you can understand very well. So student, so we are having a data of model class student and retrieve data from the student. So this is a method. So what this method is doing, this is responsible for creating an object of student and return the student. So we are having the model class object, and student view also we have to create. At the time of requirement, we can put the data directly into that. And student controller, whenever request will come, and that request will land into the student controller. In a student controller, we have to pass model and view, what is the data and what data to be displayed. And controller, we will view, update the view, and it will print into the system. And controller set name is John and update the view. So earlier the name was Robert, and now after updating, name is John. So let's run this. So student name is Robert and roll number is 10. Student name is John. Now it is changed, and after that it's reflecting here. This is a MVC design pattern. And next one is service locator. Service locator. This is also very important design pattern. Service locator. What is service locator? Service locator design pattern is used to when we want to locate various services using GNDI. So this design pattern is designed, you can see this design pattern in a GNDI lookup. GNDI lookup means Java naming service interface. We are communicating using this GNDI. Consider the high cost of looking up GNDI for a service. Service locator pattern makes use of caching technique for the first time as a service is required, and service locator looks up for GNDI and